Right.
Give me Hosea 2:12. I know so. Because if you knew, if you had knowledge, you'd be out here teaching. You'd be out here teaching. Give me Hosea 2:12. If you had knowledge, you'd be out here teaching.
I have Jeremiah.
Yeah, go ahead.
Jeremiah 14.
You thought it was the actual apple? You thought it was the apple? So what instruction did the Most High give Adam and Eve?
I'm asking you a question now. So what instruction did
the Most High give Adam and Eve?
You tell me.
I can ask you the question anyway. But this is the question that you asked.
All right.
Try to give an answer from the Bible, right?
Okay. I know it's not a literal fruit. But would you explain to me
what it was?
What it was? Give me Hebrews 5 verse 12 real quick. Give me Hebrews. Of course I got to the Bible. Of course I got to go to the Bible. Because all our answers is in the Bible. That's right. All our answers in the Bible. Give me Hebrews 5 verse 12.
Right.
I got to go to the Bible. I got to go.
It's Hebrews 5 verse 10.
Come on.
It says, but when the time ye ought to be teachers, says ye have need that one teach you again.
Come on.
It says, which your first principles of the workers of God. It says, has become a son as need milk.
Yeah, you need milk right now. You don't need Genesis. Genesis is a complicated book. Genesis, Daniel, and Revelation. You know what I mean? You can't. Hold on. Oh, no, to you. Now, give me John 3:16 and you break that down. Now, give me John 3:16, you break that down. No, my brother. Give me John 3:16, you break that down.
No, you're God. That's the way. That's the level of a
son. Come on. Yeah, come on. You're a deaconess? You're a deaconess?
You're running and you start to backtrack. You backtrack as soon as you ask the question because you know what you're doing.
I would like to say something. Anywhere I go, I'm meeting Africa with the Bible. With the Bible, what they said in the Bible, what they do in the Bible. And the bitter at the end of it all is exactly what's happening here. No love, no communication, person come back together. Why these pictures must be showed? These are past. That have no love on the ground there. No way.
Yeah,
Hey, watch me.
My money.
This is a different ground zero. We have to know the truth, and the truth is that thing only will be causing war amongst ourselves. What do you want to read?
Matthew 15:7. It says, "Ye hypocrites, well as Isaiah prophesies about you, saying."
See again.
It says, "Yes, people join near unto me with their mouth and honor me with their lips, but their hearts are far from me." It says, "But in vain they do worship me, teaching for doctrines the commandments of men." One of the commandments of men is the holidays while we were just celebrating Christmas, and I sure each and every one of them celebrate Christmas. Christmas tree in all your house.
We all know the question. He's preaching that.
Because guess what? Jeremiah 10, do not ask you themselves. Guess what? You know Christmas was celebrated 2,165 years before Christ.
Jeremiah!
So you can celebrate a man's birthday before he born. When the Christmas tree is if Christ born in 25th of December, the scriptures say, right? The wise men, they met shepherds in the field, in the middle east. Around December, it have snow. So when the sheep was doing, was on ice?
What do you think there?
No.
Jesus
said, is the way, the truth and the life. No other way but through him, the God to the Father.
That's right.
You understand? Any other God that going into the spiritual realm is climbing over.
That's right.
And teaching from the spiritual realm. Serving and choosing like the way. The way is through Jesus. That the way of the going through.
That's right. Yeah, give me John 5:23. Give me John 5:23. Yes, Shirala, you see how they get upset? You see how people get upset? Give me John 5:23. Yeah, go
John 3.
I'm not disagreeing. You was on point. But I have to go in the Bible to back what you said. You was absolutely, no, you was absolutely correct. I was just backing up what you were saying. But they're getting upset.
No, I'm not getting upset.
Now, go ahead, what you got, my son?
Love him when I give all diligence to write it to you.
Come on.
Overcome salvation.
Come on.
It was needed for me to write it to you.
Uh-huh.
And exhort you. You should earnestly contend for the faith.
Yeah, so we're going to earnestly contend in that faith. That's brother saying. He said, this Bible caused men and women to fight. Yes. Because a lot of people don't know the truth. And you're going to fight. You're going to fight, man. Contend in that faith. For what? For the truth. The scripture says, strive unto the truth unto death. We don't care what these people got to say, man. We coming with dust as a Lord. They could bacchanal, they could gossip among each other. We don't care, but we come with dust as a Lord.
Excuse me, one more thing.
Give me Jeremiah 30, verse 2, real quick. We don't care what these people got to say, man.
No, you have to care.
Right,
I'm listening to you.
Give me
Jeremiah 30, verse 2.
Come on.
For lo, the day come, said the Lord, that I will bring again the captivity of my people Israel.
Give me Isaiah 58, verse 1. That's right.
And Judah, said the Lord, and I will cause them to return to their land
on, that
I give to their fathers, and they shall possess it.
They shall what?
They shall possess it.
Now give me Isaiah 58, verse 1.
Isaiah 58, verse 1. Captivity.
Pray alone.
Israel and Judah.
Go ahead.
Pray alone, lift up thy voice and get trumpets.
Read that again.
Isaiah 58 verse 1.
Brethren.
My brethren.
Brethren.
Isaiah 58 verse 1.
Go ahead.
Pray aloud, spare not. Lift up thy voice like a trumpet.
Go ahead.
Show my people their transgression.
And say what?
Show my people their transgression.
And say, show my people their transgression.
And the house,
you know, they point fingers at me. They could do and say whatever they want. You know, they're getting upset because the word is like fire. I'm not going to answer. I'm not going to come with my own words. I'm not going to come on my own words. Now, they want us to preach in Titan words. Now, give me that real quick.
We are God.
Give me that real quick.
It's Isaiah 30 verse 9. It says that this is a rebellious people, like children, that will not hear the law of the Lord. See unto the seers, see not. And to the prophets, prophesy not to us right things.
Yeah, so they want us to prophesy right things. So we're not going to do that by prosperity doctrine. Oh, you give us some money, you don't get this blessing. Nah, we don't preach like that, man. We come with dust as the Lord. That's why a lot of these people hate us. And we're going to be hated for that name's sake. And I'm loved to be hated. Give me John 15. Give me John 15, start at 14. All right?
What about getting everybody together, boy? Why? Forcing the war. We're talking about the father, but yesterday they're forcing war.
Now, give me John 15.
It doesn't matter where they're
14
from.
And 16.
It doesn't matter where I'm from.
John 15 verse 14.
Yeah, go ahead.
Ye are my friends, if you do whatsoever I command you.
So whatever the Most High command us, we gotta do it. We gotta come with dust, says the Lord. We don't care what they saying and bickering and talking gossip about us. People gonna gossip about us. People gonna hate us. Go ahead.
Hold on.
Go ahead.
Henceforth I call you not servants.
I'm gonna let you speak. Go ahead.
Henceforth I call you not servants,
uh-huh,
for the servants do it me.
Come on.
Sorry, henceforth I call you not servants, for the servant do it not what is his Lord do it.
Uh-huh.
But I have called you friends, for all things that I have heard of my Father, I have made known unto you.
Keep reading.
Ye have not chosen me, but I have chosen you.
Yeah, so the Most High chose us to come out and preach to the nation of Israel. And we're going to be hated. They killed the prophets of the Lord. They saw them in half, man. They got Jesus hung, man. You know, so this is a specter right here, man. Our own people, man. So go ahead,
that ye should go and bring forth fruit.
That we should go and bring forth fruit. Go ahead.
And that, that,
and that your fruit shall remain.
That your fruit shall remain. Come on.
That whatsoever ye shall ask of the Father in my name.
Ask my Father in my name. They don't know the name of Jesus Christ. They think it's Jesus. The word J, the letter J came in 1524. So what is it? What was his name before? They saying Jesus. Jehovah. That's not even his name. You know, go ahead,
right? He may give it to you. These things I command you, that ye love one another.
That we love one another. I do love my people. That's why I'm out here in the streets. Go ahead.
If the world hates you.
If the world hates you like these people, we hate it. Right? They gossiping. But if I was Jack Warden up here, all of them be quiet right now. If I was Jay-Z, all of them be quiet. If I was Montano, all of them be quiet. But since I come up with dust as the Lord, they talking about me. They speaking evil of me. But it's all good. That's part of the job. Go ahead.
If the world hates you.
If the what?
If the world hates you.
If the world hates you, go ahead.
He know that it hated me before it hated you.
Guess what? Y'all hated John the Baptist. Y'all hated Jesus Christ. And we're going to be hated. And I'm happy that y'all hate me. I'm happy that y'all talk about me. I'm happy. Now read that. Read.
If he were of the world. If he were of the world.
Yo, if I was of the world, if I was Montano singing and performing, it's a yeah, boy. Yeah, boy.
Do you believe in Christ?
Go ahead.
If he were of the world, the world would love his own.
It say the world would what?
Would love his own.
Yeah, the world would love his own. The world love his own, man. If I was Jaquil, if I was Egyptian up here, they would love me, man. But since I'm coming with dust of the Lord, every time I come with the scriptures, they say, boy, speak your own word, boy. I'm saying, give me John 15:24. Boy, speak your own word, boy. How am I answer my people without the word of the Heavenly Father?
Yeah. But because ye are not of the world, but I have chosen you out of the world.
Yeah, so I'm not of the world. We not of the world. Go ahead.
But I have chosen you out of the world. Come on. Therefore, the world hates you.
The world what?
Hated you.
The world what?
Hated you.
Yeah, we hate it, man. We hate it. That's why David said, we are killed all day long, man.
We love
it. It's first Corinthians
2:7.
It says, but we speak the wisdom of God in a mystery.
Yeah, so we speak the wisdom of God in a mystery. Go ahead.
It says, even the hidden wisdom.
The hidden wisdom. This word was hidden to 2/3 of our people, man. That's why they gossiping among one another. Because Christ said, if they was mine, they were here. And none of them going to be plucked out of my hand.
He wrote in a book. It says, which God ordained before the world.
Come on.
Unto our glory. It says, which none of the princes of this world knew, or had they known it, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory.
Yeah, that's right. They would not crucify the Lord of glory, man. Go ahead.
This is Isaiah 65:1.
Read on.
I am sought of them that ask not for me. I am found of them that sought me not. I said, behold me, unto a nation that was not called by my name.
Yeah, that called by not my name. They don't know the name of their Father. That's why the mystery, the key, that I give it to them, because they don't know the name of the Heavenly Father. The name is in Hebrew. When Christ was on earth, he spoke what? He spoke Hebrew. So he have a Hebrew name. Jesus is a Greek name. And a lot of y'all don't know what Jesus means. See how the sisters are constantly talking? You see it? Yeah, but that's
what I have spread out my hands all day unto a rebellious people, which walking in their own way, a way that was not good, after their own thoughts, and people that provoked me to anger.
I said people that provoked me to anger. Go ahead.
Continually to my face.
Continue to my face.
That sacrifices and gardens.
Uh-huh. Yeah. And God is representing these churches. Go ahead.
And burnt incense.
And burnt incense. These prayers. Go ahead. Go ahead.
Which remain among the graves and lodge in the monument.
Uh-huh.
Which eat swine's flesh.
Yeah, after they done with church, they go eat pork. After they done with church, they go eat pork, man. And you're not supposed to eat pork. You know what I'm saying? You're not supposed to eat pork. That's against the law.
But eat swine flesh and broths of abominable things in their vessels.
And that's why a lot of these women is out of shape because of what they eat. You're not supposed to be eating white flour. Hold on. You're not supposed to eat pork. That's why these women are so big on this island. And the Most High gave his dietary laws on how to eat. That's when you read Daniel, he show you how to eat. Eat wheat and eat legumes. You know, eat vegetables. That's the way you lose weight, by eating the way Danny was eating.
You can't.
Now give me Romans 15:4. You can say whatever.
Daddy will have lost weight, but
give me Romans 15:4.
It's Amos 5:10. It says, Amos 5:10.
Come on.
They hate them that rebuke in the gate.
Yeah, so they hate them that rebuke in the gate.
And
and abhor him that speaketh uprightly.
They abhor him that speaketh uprightly. So they hate me. You know, they hate us. You know?
Romans 15 verse 4.
Come on.
Whatsoever things were written aforetime.
So whatever was written in this Bible, the Old Testament, go ahead.
Were written for our learning.
Was written for our what?
For our learning.
It was written for our learning.
That we through patience and comfort of the scriptures might have hope.
Might have hope, man. So we believe in this Bible, man.
There's Matthew 10 and 24. The disciple is not above his master, nor the servant above his lord. It says it is enough for the disciple that he be as his master, and the servant as his lord. It says if they have called the master the house of Beelzebub, how much more shall they call his household?
That's right. Yeah, they was calling him Beelzebub. They was calling him Satan. They was calling Christ Beelzebub. Now give me 2 Corinthians 10 verse 8. Give me 2 Corinthians 10 verse 8.
I want to see signs and wonders. We showed it to you, my sister. So you want what you perform?
Did I qualify? Did I qualify directly?
No.
I was on to the camera.
No, listen.
I wasn't qualified.
I want you to work miracle. I want you to work miracle now. Signs and wonders.
Can I give it to you?
It's Matthew 16 verse 4. It says, a wicked and adulterous generation seeketh after a sign, and there shall not a sign be given unto them. It says, but the sign of the prophet Jonas.
Go on. So sister, can I give you the answer, sister? Sister, can I give you the answer? Sister, can I give you the answer?
Sorry,
1 Corinthians 12, verse 9, real quick. Give me that real quick. 1 Corinthians 12, verse 9. I can help you, my sister. I can help you.
Alright,
I'm going to put some miracle on you. Let's listen. Give me 1 Corinthians.
The right guy.
Give me 1 Corinthians 12, verse 9.
1 Corinthians
12,
verse 9.
Go ahead.
I want the last 10 pounds right now.
Or medicines. I think it's one of the signs.
First Corinthians 9.
Yeah, go ahead.
To another faith by the same spirit. To another gift.
I say another gift. I'm giving an answer. I say another gift of healing. So when you look up that word healing, that's somebody that specializes in medicine and herbs. Okay? So if I come put hands on you, you ain't gonna be 100 pounds one time.
But they have a prophet in Trinidad and Tobago. If he said the lost with, you're lost in with. You understand? Me not see, I tell you.
If you have a demon on you, he will tell you you have a demon on you.
Signs and wonders.
A lot of y'all got demons on you. Go ahead.
You see?
Give me on 38.
You see a death touch meeting?
I say Lottie, I ain't say you, my sister. I say Lottie, I ain't say you. Did I say you? Did I say sister with the brown? I ain't say you. And first of all, we can judge. Now give me 2 Corinthians 2. We can judge. Give me 1 Corinthians 6, 1 and 2. Give me 1 Corinthians 6, 1 and 2.
No, God is not the author of
confusion. Yeah, give me 5. I like what she said. I like what she said. She said, I like what the sister said. She said, God is not an author of confusion. Now, who's bringing confusion in the church's Corinth? The woman. That's why Paul said, let the woman keep the silence in the church. Because he was bringing a lot of confusion.
You are children.
Now, give me that real quick.
Yeah, we are children.
Give me 1 Corinthians.
Yes.
So you are violent. Six. Don't be violent for me.
1 Corinthians 6 verse 2.
I'm Elijah, my sister, and she said something about judging. Now go ahead, my brother.
Do ye not know that the same shall judge the world? That if the world shall
know about the judge, back to the world.
Then read again. Read.
Do ye not know that the same shall judge the world? That if the world shall be judged by you, are ye unworthy to judge the smallest
matter? Yeah, so are we unworthy to judge the smallest matter? Yeah, we're coming here to judge our people. Why people doing wickedness?
Yeah.
We're going to tell you. If you're smoking cocaine or crack or smoking weed, we're going to tell you through the scriptures, hey, you defile your temple.
Yeah, yeah.
That's our judgment.
Holy judgment. Righteous judgment, my brother.
Yeah, righteous judgment. Holy judgment. I don't know how you want to put it, but this is what I'm telling you.
So, my sister's a prostitute.
You can't watch me and tell me I'm smoking weed if you never see the smoke weed.
I was giving an example.
You could only judge me on my own appearance and my activity.
Deuteronomy 1:16. Yeah. And I charge you, judges, hey, at Acts, that time.
Give me Exodus 18. Yeah. Give me Exodus 18, 21, 22. Read on.
That's why it's important to study.
It's Deuteronomy 1:16. And I charge your judges at that time.
Yeah, I said I charge your judges at the time. The Most High raised up men to be judges. If men couldn't judge, why they had the book of Judges? Now Samson judging Israel, Ehud, Shemgar, Gideon judges the nation of Israel. So what the hell are you talking about? We can't judge. If our people